I don't know if you can hear this at all in the videos, or if I should even point it out, but I swear there's like a small airplane that is just circling above my house as I'm trying to record these videos. It just keeps coming in and out. Hopefully that's not being picked up on this microphone. Well, anyway, when we left off, we'd created a little form, and the form currently doesn't do anything. If I click on it, it doesn't do anything. And so where is this information going? What is it going to do when I click on it? And this is where we get to the M in MVC. We're going to work with models, and models have everything to do with the data, storing data, retrieving data, manipulating data. Everything data related happens through the models. And so that's what we're going to do, is go in and create a model. And we're going to need in our model a spot for each of these pieces of information. So we'll need a first name, last name, age, phone, major, occupation. Are you a creeper stalker? All of that information is going to be stored in a database eventually, but at first we need to put it into a model, which is just a class. And so just like we create other classes, we're going to store that information as an object. And so how do we do that? Well, let's go in our models folder. Now I thought I deleted this, but maybe I hadn't. And so let's delete our error view model. We're not using it. So we'll delete that. And then I'm going to come into the models folder, and I'll say, right click on the models folder and say add a new item. And the item we want to add, as you look through to try and find a model, there's no such thing. A model is just a class. All right, so a model is just a class, and you think that they're going to create instances of this class, as each time the user clicks submit application, it's going to build an instance of this class that holds that particular data. And so what do we want to call it? And so I'm going to call it application singular. This isn't applications. This isn't a number of application. This is an application template that when we create an instance of it will be one application. And then we create another instance and we have another application. We can create another instance. We have another application. If we take those three application objects together, then they could be known as applications, but the template is to create a application singular. I think this is helpful if you do it this way. It'll help us when we connect up with the database. And so we're going to create an application singular class, so CS. We add that, and it will build for us just a little class like we would create in any program where we're creating a class. So a public class called application. And then in here, we can start to build the variables, so to speak, that are in this application. And so what do we want? Well, we're first going to, and just picture this, you know, with the database background that you have, that we would want to have in here just as if we were building a table, and this is eventually going to become a table with these fields in it. And so what I'm going to do is create probably first an int called application ID, and that is going to be our primary key for this particular table that we're building eventually. Again, this model gets turned into a table at some point in the near future. And so with this, typically that's all we do. But with each of these pieces of data, as you're writing programs, a lot of times you'll develop then methods to be able to access that data. Like I say, we typically don't want other outside applications accessing our data directly. We want to control that interaction of how they interact with our data. And so a very common thing in programming is to create something called getters and setters, and they're very simple. We just create a method. If somebody wants to access the application ID, we say, yeah, we'll let you do that. We'll send you an int and call it, And then we'll create a method called get application ID. And you don't have to pass us anything. And all we're going to do is return whatever is in our application ID variable. That way, the user, or not the user, but other developers, application ID, are not accessing our variable directly. They access it through a little method where we can then put it in rules and say, you can only access it if you're this user level, or meaning like it's security level, or that, you know, some sort of rules that you want to put in about accessing that data. And then we also will add in a lot of times, likewise, we're going to give them a way to edit the application ID. And so we don't typically return anything out of this, but we create a method called set application ID. And we do, if we're going to set it, need them to pass in an integer that will set this ID and just call it num or whatever. And then we have a little method that goes in and says, okay, go set our variable application ID equal to whatever was passed in num. And then that way the variable gets set. But again, we can implement our own rules here. It can't be a negative number. It has to be a number between this and this. It has to be a number that's in the database, and or not in the database in this case if it's a primary key. And so we create with any variables we create, it's very common to then have a getter, we call this a getter, and a setter. Okay, we have a getter and a setter. And so we typically would do this. Well, ASP.NET, again, always in an effort to make programming easier. They want to be the programming language that everybody uses. And so instead of us having to go in and create these methods, they say, hey, if you'll just put in braces and say get, comma, set. If you'll do that without the semicolon on the end, then we will automatically for you build these getters and setters so that you don't need to build those methods. And so on each of our pieces of information we're going to store for in this form, we will create getters and setters. Now, if I don't want them to be able to set it, I can remove the set and it will just be a get. What's this? That is a read-only variable. I only allow them to get it, they can't set it. And so, and I guess there might be a situation where you only want them to set it and not be able to get it, I don't know. And so anyway, we're gonna wanna put getters and setters with each of our pieces of information. And so which pieces of information do we need? Well, I need a first name and a last name. And so what type of information is that? Well, those are gonna be strings. So again, data types come into play here. So public string, and I'm gonna call this one first name, and it's going to have my getters and setter properties on it. And I'll put the getter and setter back on this one as well. I need a public string last name. Now it's even doing it for me. Okay. It's trying to do more stuff, which is to put a default value in it. What else do I need? I need a public string, or I don't know if it's a string. Where's my form? What else do I need? I need to open up my in my views. Let's go back to the dating application. I need one for the age. What type of information that is that going to be? Well, that'll be an integer called age, and I can create get set for that. What else do I need? I got to have the phone number. Well, what type of information is that? Well, it's going to have hyphens in it most likely, and so I can't store it as a number, so it'll be a string. Phone number, get and set. Okay. They don't need to match exactly what we put in the other boxes. We're going to tie that up in a minute. Okay, major, occupation. So I need a public string to store the major with its get and set. Again, thinking all the time, this is eventually going to be a database. The public string for occupation and its get and set. And then I need the last one is this idea of whether they're a creeper stalker. And so what type of information is that one going to be? And I'm going to leave you on a cliffhanger because we're going to figure that out in the next video. And then we're going to tie all this information that's in our model to the form. See you in a minute. Spencer out.